Hello and welcome back to the channel. If you're new, please hit the subscribe button. If you're returning, thanks for coming back. We're now at the point where we're going to push out the end cap bearings in the Jackson Racing Supercharger. As I said before, I have the special tool, the correct size of the diameter bearing, the transmission tool that I have, and then a regular half-inch drive or extension. Or you can use a 7/16 socket. Either one. We're going to press them out and shoot them down into the housing. And if you remember before, we took a reading and it was 18/1000ths of an inch down below the casting. So hopefully we can get this thing pushed out. There it goes. Fell through. So we're going to continue that for the other side, get everything cleaned out and prepped to push the new ones in. We got the first end cap bearing pressed in. If you notice there's some green dye in there, that's because I had to put some bearing, Loctite bearing lock in there because the cap went in kind of sideways and galled the aluminum. Make sure that you have it securely flush. That's why I stopped about halfway down to look, and it is. Take a little bit of emery cloth and clean the hole out inside. I think that a little bit of crud got in there and made the bearing cap tilt while I was pressing it in, but that should be fine like that. I cleaned out the bore and everything and it went in smooth. So I'm just going to keep going down, making sure it's straight. It's going in nice and smooth. And you get it about where the other one is and start taking your measurements, and it was 18/1000ths of an inch. Once you get it pressed down, you want to look at, make sure the caps are level, and then go ahead and take your dial caliper and recheck. So if we look, that's 18/1000ths. Okay, once you get the bearing set down and everything measured out, we're going to go ahead and put the rotor housing assembly in. Make sure it's perfectly clean and blew out. We want to get this thing sealed up so no dirt or debris get inside the needle bearing housings down there and cause wear on the rotors. So we'll get that all cleaned up and get them inserted. Jackson Racing Supercharger rotor pack. I'm getting it prepped to go back into the housing, and it had some type of epoxy coating over the lobes and it was chipped off in a lot of spots. So I wanted to just go ahead and strip it all off and see if we can't still build a good amount of boost. I have it soaking in some acetone. You don't ever want to soak this underside here. I believe there's two seals back there. This side is oil bathed, so I'll flip it around and soak this side, but we're going to let it soak and then we'll flip it over and scrape off what little epoxy was left over and go ahead and inspect the back housing and everything else. As you can see, it bubbled up the epoxy coating pretty well. I'm just going to take a soft nylon brush and you want to go ahead and just get it off there and see how easy that comes off. Now again, I am doing the cheapest way to get this thing back on the road and get it building boost. So if you're not, you know, if you don't feel comfortable with doing it or you're not building any boost, send it off and get it recoated and reconditioned. As long as these blades ain't too bad, they'll trade it in for a core. Let's get all this epoxy off here, this coating, and we'll get into cleaning it and inspecting it. Okay, we got all the pieces cleaned up. So we're going to give them one final quick wipe down. Make sure you have your bolts and everything laid out. Quick inspection of the rotors showed that they were hitting, and I apologize for the lighting. See if that helps a little bit. There was some touching up here and that was because the front case needle bearing, they were probably damaged or whatnot, worn out. So I'm not going to touch any of this. I'm going to leave this alone the way it is because we polished the inside and smoothed everything down, so there should be enough clearance with the new bearings to where this won't touch, and I'll just leave it as is. So yeah, have everything laid out, ready to go. Here's where people make a big, big mistake. This is the only sealant you can really use in this, because one, it's an aluminum housing. You don't want to use RTV. And two, anaerobic is just the preferred seal when you're doing superchargers. So this is where people get messed up, and they end up blobbing on RTV. Then they get leaks and all that stuff. So we'll get a line around there after I get it wiped off, and I'll show you guys exactly how to set it in. Okay, this was the part that I was talking about everybody gets messed up on. You see how it's just a thin line going all the way around the outside area of the flange. I'm going to smooth that in ever so slightly with my finger, and then set the rotor housing assembly into there. I put a little bit of grease on the end of the supercharger lobes. This is a very special grease. Don't put regular grease in there, it will destroy it. It's a special tube of grease that I had to order. So I always add that for a little protection. Extra lube didn't hurt. So we'll smooth it out, take a look at it, and then drop the rotors in. All right, as you can see, I just barely smoothed it out. I'm gonna drop the rotor assembly in, and then we're gonna get the other side with some anaerobic sealer and put the tail cap on. Okay, same thing here. I spread it out with my finger. Got it all spread in. So let's get the back snout dropped on, lined up. We got a new coupler in there. And we'll get everything sealed in. Okay, once you got the rotor housing in and the snout, you want to go ahead and finger tighten all the bolts around. If you notice, one bolt's different. I dropped one somewhere, and it's dark out, so I can't find it. And I want the anaerobic sealer to dry, so I had another bolt laying around that I just used real quick. So you snug them all down, and then when it give about an hour or so, and then do the final torque is about 18 to 20 foot-pounds. I do it by hand, and then you just want to check and make sure everything's spinning nice by hand, which it is. Don't hear no metal. I checked the lobes in and out and made sure there was no play, so all the play was gone that was in it. And I'll show that once I load it up with some oil. This happens to take AC Delco oil. I believe the charge is 4 ounces, so we'll get it on the vise, get the syringe filled, and start filling it in the charge port. Alright, I like to use the syringe to fill it up. It's about 60 milliliters, so it's about 2 ounces. A little under 2 ounces. People use this to empty it, but I use it to fill it as well. Take out the drain plug. Let's get it filled up until it's right even with those threads. Okay, we got everything mounted up in the vise. We're going to go ahead and spin it in reverse with a drill. Let's listen for any abnormal noise. Pretty smooth. Sounds good. So yeah, we'll get it cleaned up, make sure the oil level's good after running it for a little bit. Sorry, my battery just died. Well, it's starting to die. So we'll get it cleaned up. We'll get the oil level topped off after everything's spinning in there from being dry. The pulley looks nice. Everything's good to go. And yeah, inside here on the back plate, just check for any leftover anaerobic sealer. Wipe it off with a rag. If you're not going to put it on your car right away, tape it up. If you are, it's ready to bolt on. So if you stuck with me through this whole little series here, you've rebuilt your Eaton M45 Supercharger, commonly found on the Hondas. So we'll get into the S-tube and all the other pieces that commonly fail on in the next videos. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe.